I think if Dilly Heart, Hoska's Village, and Streets of Paris had a baby, that would be Champa Gali. It's a small little lane in Saket. If you can't find it, Google map it. You'll find the directions. This charming hideaway is a potpourri of all things good. Art, culture, chai, coffee, and yummy food. The usual charm of backyards in Delhi, with unusual folks hanging there, will make you feel like you're close. So supposedly, this is the new Hoska's Village, because, you know, Hoska's Village has become too commercial and is not as hip anymore. So this place is still quite hidden from the world, and that's what makes this place amazing. You'll usually find vloggers here snapping away for the gram, and since there's a lot of graffiti on the walls, be sure to get in some cool pictures. Now, if you're here with your friends, great. You'll have a blast regardless. But if you're exploring this place on your own, maybe want to feel like a tourist for a day in your own city, then I've got some tips for you. Tip number one, grab a coffee at Blue Tokai and get yourself energized. So I come here to get some work done, listen to music, read a book, and have their really delicious artisan coffees. I've ordered chili cinnamon mocha. Yeah, I said that right. And let's see. It's pretty good. Tip number two. When you're starting to tire out, you know, from the general fatigue of doing nothing, treat yourself with some shopping. There are these pop-up boutiques selling quirky ethnic jewelry, unique books, music records, Indian clothes, which I love, by the way. And you know what that called for? Well, that called for an impromptu fashion show. Look at this. This is made of elephant poop, and this is made of horse poop. And it doesn't smell like it, which is amazing. So these can be some cool new additions to your fridge. Tip number three. It's time for lunch. So find a cafe that resonates with your mood. Now you can go for one of the fancier Fur King, that sounds weird, or the Rose Cafe. But I settled for this quaint little one called Patta Cafe. So this is run by a small Tibetan family, and they have authentic Northeastern cuisine. Like they have Tibetan, Bhutanese, Nepalese, even Naga cuisine. The reason I came here is because I'm friends with the owner, which brings me to tip number four. Say you're not from the city and want to interact with the locals. It can get a bit awkward to go up to random people's table and try and start a conversation. Instead, you can talk to the staff or the owner, ask them about their establishment. They'll usually talk about it very passionately. And just like that, you've made a new friend. So this is Ramya. Say hi.
Hi.
So the last time I came here, we got chatting. She told me how they came up about the place, and she even gave me a few free dishes on the side. So,
did you
remember
doing that?
She did. But what do you think I should go for today? Yeah, okay, so I've ordered Tibetan tea, which I didn't know is milky, and thukpa and these folk momos. And I'm gonna be honest, I was super hungry, so I've already had like six of them. Here's like the seventh one. It's with this really spicy chutney. And tip number five, take your sweet little time to click those pictures for your Insta story. Because there's nobody to tell you. Can you hurry up? The food's getting cold. Linger on here from noon till evening. There's plenty to absorb.
Okay. Fun fact,
I just crossed by that lane and I could smell grass in the open, which full on gave me Bangalore vibes and automatically makes this place super cool.
As the night rolls in and fairy lights come on, Champa Gali unveils an altogether different face. Tip number 6. End your day with a sweet cup of chai at the Jagmug Thela. This place is symbolic to Champa Gali. Let's go check it out. So, I've read that if you donate a book here, you get free chai and cookies. Yay! So, since I already knew that, I got this book. It's actually my brother's. And let's see if that works. So, before I came here, I read a blog where the blogger said that this place reminded him of Diagon Alley, you know, with these secret passages leading to artistic wonderlands. And I'd say I agree with him. So, come here, keep an open mind, and let the magic flow in. And here's my final tip. Tip number 7. Be proud of yourself for exploring this place on your own. Because you see, not everyone is comfortable being in their own company. So pat yourself on the back for being just by yourself and freaking nailing it. Hi guys! So I had a lot of fun shooting this video and I hope you had fun watching it too. So if you do end up coming to Champa Gali, click your pictures and tag me on Instagram with the hashtag GazOnTheGo and I'll find it and I'll like it. And if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you next week with another video. Ciao!